Are you thinking about moving to Malta in 2024 and you're trying to figure it out how to move here? What is the cost of living? What are the job opportunities and visa types? Come along with me in this video because I'll be breaking down every point that you need to know if you would like to make Malta your next home. Welcome back to my YouTube channel, guys. It's Alex here. Just in case you're bumping for the first time on my channel, my name is Alex and I create videos about Malta ever since 2021. In today's video, as you can see from the thumbnail, the title and the intro of this video, I'll be giving you out information if you would like to make Malta home now in 2024. Guys, it's currently 9:30 in the morning, 17th of February, and this video is going live in about an hour from now. So I need to record it, I need to edit it, and I need to post it for you guys. So I don't want to ramble a lot, I would like to go straight into the point so that you can understand what Malta has to offer and whether it is still a good decision for you to make the move. The very first thing that I would like to talk about is about the residence permits in Malta and the visa types. Just in case you're coming from the European Union, there is no any requirements about visa. You can just move into Malta, look for a job opportunity, or start a business. More details about this that I just mentioned is going to be created in another video. So make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel and stay tuned if you would like to see more. Now, what about those people that are coming from the non-European Union countries? Guys, depends on which country you are coming from. Let's say the Balkan countries and some of the Latin countries, you can come to Malta and stay for 3 months and meanwhile try to look for a job opportunity. However, there are other countries, for example, the South Asian countries, where you do need to get a visa for you to enter in Malta. And of course, you do need to have a work permit, residence permit, to legally reside and work in Malta. Now, there is something new that is happening in 2024, especially for non-European Union people who are planning to work in Malta in the hospitality and catering sector. Guys, there is a new card that has been introduced from this year that costs around 500 euros, and it is for you to apply if you are working in the hospitality sector. Once you pass the tests, you're going to get this card and now you're eligible to apply for a work permit. This is a very complex topic, so I need to make a whole dedicated video about it. But for now, have a look at the description of this video where you will find the link about more information about this new hospitality card. Just in case if you're someone who is working for a foreign company somewhere out of Malta and you're having, let's say, more than 3,000 euros salary, you are eligible to apply for a digital nomad visa to live in Malta. A dedicated video about this I already have, it's linked down in the description of this video. As well, the official link from the residency agency in Malta, it's linked down in the description of this video. Please have a look at it to see all the requirements, how you can apply for this visa. However, here I would like to say, just in case you're planning to move to Malta as a digital nomad, please pay attention. While you are under this type of visa, you do not have legal rights to do any type of business in Malta. Just in case there is someone of you watching and it's planning to purchase a property in Malta, you have two options. If you purchase a property and invest into NGOs in Malta, and all of this, it's roughly around 1 million euros, straight away you are eligible for a Maltese passport. A dedicated video about this is coming up, so stay tuned on my YouTube channel. However, there is something else which is very important, and this is about getting a residence permit if you are buying a property in Malta. In case you buy a property of a value from 220,000 euros onwards in the south part of Malta, you are getting a residence permit. Or if you are buying a property that is minimum 275,000 and it is in the central or in the northern part of Malta, as well you are going to be eligible for a residence permit. Now, once you're settled down and you have a visa to live in Malta and work in Malta, where you should live? This is a very complex topic and I will break it down very briefly for you to understand what Malta has to offer. Let's put the map over here. Malta is divided into the central part, the northern part, and the south part of Malta. All these three different regions of Malta are offering something completely different. Does this sentence make sense? The central part of Malta, the main points are Sliema, St. Julian's and Valletta, Valletta being the capital city of Malta. Just in case you're planning to live in any of these areas, guys, please pay attention. These are one of the most expensive areas to rent an apartment in Malta, if not even to buy an apartment in Malta. Now, another option that I would give you out here, you can rent a property somewhere in the surrounding areas. For example, if you would like to be quite closer to Valletta, you can rent an apartment somewhere in Pieta, Vgura, Hamrun, Guardamangia. These are more affordable rather than living in Valletta. Now, this is a place for those of you that you are going to work somewhere in Valletta. However, if you're someone who is getting a job opportunity to work in Sliema or St. Julian's, if you can fork out from 1,000 euros 200 onwards, then you can live in one of these areas. But pay attention that they're extremely busy and noisy. However, if you would like to have something that it's, let's say, around 800 or 900 euros, then look for an apartment either in Xira, Emsida, or even San Juan. They are on a walking distance from Sliema and St. Julian's. Now, before I continue, something that I would say as a tip is if you're planning to make Malta your home for a couple of years or more, I would definitely suggest you to invest into a car straight away. I was without a car for 5 years because I was living in a central part of Malta. And I always had to spend money if you would like to go to the beaches, if you would like to go to the north part or the south part or to the airport, or when I have friends visiting, you know. Taxis, they can be expensive if you're using them on a daily basis. But having a car in Malta, roughly you're going to spend around 120 to 160 euros monthly for petrol, depending on what type of car you have. And of course, depending on how much you're driving this car. Now here I'm jumping a little bit into the cost of living in Malta, so the part about the petrol is here. However, let's move on to the south part of Malta. If you would like to live in the south part of Malta, here you can find some areas that are more quiet and as well more green. So those of you that would like to have more kind of like a peaceful lifestyle, this is the area for you. Now, from the other hand, the northern part of Malta, it's a little bit more busy, especially the area of St. Paul's Bay, Melija and Aura, considering that it's also the area where over the summertime there is a lot of tourists. Even in the winter time. These areas are full of resorts and hotels. I have briefly told you about where to live in Malta, but I do have videos related to the accommodation in Malta and areas where you would live, and they're going to be linked down in the description of this video, but I'm pretty sure that I need to make an updated version because the prices of the rents are changing. Speaking about, here we are moving on to the other part of the video about the cost of living and as well the rental prices in Malta. Guys, every year the prices in Malta are just going up when it comes to the cost of living, when it comes to the rent, but the salaries, they're quite stagnant. They're not moving. Or if they're moving, they're not in the same ratio with the cost of living. From what I have seen so far, the minimum that you can find when it comes to renting an apartment in Malta, it's 700 euros. And it can be even in the south, even in the north, even in like the worst areas of Malta. The prices are really obnoxious. I have seen that people are subletting rooms into their apartments for even whooping 600 euros for a room with an ensuite. And if you do not have an ensuite, the room is going to be 500 euros. Like, the prices have gone sky high. However, there are still several apartments that you can find, considering that there is a constant construction in Malta, that are going to be somewhere around 700 euros. This, when it comes to renting an apartment in Malta, you can either do it online. Somewhere where I really suggest people to look into is the groups about accommodation in Malta on Facebook. Like, always you will find something that has been updated, whether it's from a real estate agent or directly from the owner. Now, those of you that you can spend a little bit more, the safest part for you is just if you go to a real estate agency to rent a property. You will always have the agent behind you that is going to offer you anything that is available on the market. You can negotiate with the landlord as well to decrease the rent a little bit. And as I said, renting through a real estate is one of the safest options. Now, the last part that we are coming about the cost of living in Malta, I have to make a dedicated video about the prices in Malta. Usually I do this every year, sometimes I'm doing 3 times per year, of giving you how much are the prices in Malta right now in the supermarkets, and I'm comparing them, let's say from the beginning of the year until the end of the year, how much they increased or decreased. Usually they just increase. So I think I'm going to make a dedicated video and going around supermarkets in Malta. Maybe it will come out in the next few weeks. So again, stay tuned to my YouTube channel. But for now, what I can give you is just roughly how much you will be spending on groceries if you're planning to live in Malta. If you are a single person living in Malta, definitely you're spending minimum 300 euros per month on groceries. But guys, this is very subjective considering of what type of food you eat. If you eat organic food, of course, the price will go even more. If you are a family, if you are a couple, couples usually in Malta spend somewhere between 400 and 600 euros. And of course, again, depending on the type of food that you eat. Now, if you're wondering where I'm getting these prices from, I'm getting these prices when I ask people on the actual group of expats in Malta on Facebook. I always do some type of survey so I can get more information of other expats that are living in Malta. Now, if you're a family of four, definitely you're going to spend between 600 up to 1,000 euros per month. I know that this is a lot of money, but as I said, this is for a family of four. I think that this video can go on and on and on for like half an hour. But I want you guys to use the comment section of this video to ask questions. I will be answering them, and I know that other expats who are living in Malta are going to help you and give you more information about life in Malta. So feel free to use the comment section and give me any type of comments that you have or any questions so that I can help you out if you're planning to make Malta a living home. I hope with this video, guys, you got further information about Malta. I hope I helped you. If I did, please make sure to like the video down below. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and until I see you in my next one. Bye.